Hi. Welcome to Movies Reflexed. Today I am going to explain a horror mystery movie titled Saw 2. Watch out for spoilers, take care. The movie starts and we see a guy named Michael, who became the victim of jigsaw killing. And he finds himself in an unknown room stuck in a life-threatening helmet. Jigsaw sends him message using videotape, where he finds the reason of being here. Actually, Michael was a police spy who used to tell the police about other people's. According to Jigsaw, he ruined the life of many people by making them arrested by the police. According to the rules of Jigsaw's game, he was left with only 1 minute. Now, before his helmet gets locked and he dies, Jigsaw gives him a hint that the key to the helmet has been fixed at the back of his eye. Today was his assessment whether he could sacrifice his eye, which he kept on other people's. In order to save his own life, Michael tries much to dig out the key, but all goes in vain. At last, the timer ends and his face gets shattered away. On the other side, we see that Detective Eric and his son had an argument. He gets angry and orders his son to leave. But after a while, when he regretted this decision, he tries to go back to him. But his son Daniel was lost, and there was no information. Then another detective named Allison calls Eric about the investigation of crime scene of Michael. Because Michael had left a note for Eric on the wall. And here we come to know that Michael was informer of Eric. And he used to send information to Eric. After reading the note on the wall and logo on helmet, he understands from where these masks were manufactured. And finally, Eric finds out the secret and exact location of Jigsaw with the help of other detectives. Where they find Jigsaw is a weak person suffering from cancer. There they find out that they have not founded Jigsaw. In fact, he did smart planning. So as to trap them, there they see footages on monitors that Jigsaw had kept. Michael's son Daniel and many others were in a room filled with poisonous gas. And those people were left with only 2 hours before they die of poisonous gas. Jigsaw also tells Eric that only those people were locked inside whom he arrested against false evidences. And he did all of that with the help of Michael. And up until now, people who were trapped never knew that Daniel was Michael's son. Otherwise, they would have killed him for his father. Jigsaw tells Eric that if he wants, he can save his son. And it would only be possible if he follows the rules of his game. The rules of Jigsaw's game was quite simple, that one has to understand Jigsaw's message perfectly. According to the rules of the game, he agrees to talk to him alone. During the conversation, Eric finds out that Jigsaw knows him very well. Like Eric used to torture his prisoners very badly when he was police officer 5 years ago. Only so that they could admit their crime. And once he broke the teeth of a prisoner. And not only this, but he also managed to make false charges against the criminals. He tells him the reason of him becoming Jigsaw. As to him, people don't know the importance of life. And they don't develop surviving skills until they see the death in front of them. Like Eric felt for his son at that moment. He understands that humans have much power to tolerate pain. And he wanted to tell the people about the importance of their life by his violent way. Jigsaw says that he has a sign, which he imprints on the bodies of those who don't survive the game. On the other side, all the prisoners were trying to find out their reason for being here. There were people who never knew each other. Amanda finds out the tape of Jigsaw. In which they find out that they were left with 2 hours until the poisonous gas kills them. In order to survive, they have to find the hidden antidote in the room. The secret code of which Jigsaw tells them in form of a puzzle. That the code was fixed at the back of their brain in the color of rainbow. Jigsaw also tells them that they were all present here because of only one reason. The clue of which they would find out from the X mask hidden in the house. With that recorder, they also find a key and a note. In which Jigsaw warned them not to open the door with the key. But Xavier denies Jigsaw's rule and tries to open the door with the key. But by doing so, the trigger of the gun opens up, and the guy looking through the keyhole dies. Jigsaw intentionally provided the door key for 2 reasons. Because he knew that someone would try to open the door despite his warning. And he would die. And the other reason was to tell the people that the rules must be followed. Otherwise they would suffer the same fate. After some times, The room's door opens up by itself. And they find no way out, even after searching the entire house. Then they find the door to the basement. And going inside, they find the Jigsaw's new message, a pale any many other things. They also find a name, Obi. And that was one of the prisoners' name. They find out that Obi was the reason that they were here. But he himself never knew that why was he here. Jigsaw tells them that he had put the two antidotes in a box. And one of them was Obi's gift for kidnapping all of them, and also bringing them here. And the second one was for one of the prisoners. This recorded message was actually a puzzle which meant to say that, when you are in hell, only the devil can save you. And with that, the message ends. But no one cares about that. When Obi's name was revealed, then Xavier threatens to kill him. But Obi never gets frightened. He goes inside the kiln to find the antidotes. And he successfully takes out one of the antidotes. But when he opted to take the second antidote, the door of the kiln shuts down by itself. And it catches fire and Obi dies here. And that antidote also vanishes from there. Then they find out another room, and the timer of that room triggers up. After listening the tape, they find out that this room was actually a test room for Xavier. Xavier is a drug dealer who is involved in putting people under addiction to drugs. In this test, Xavier had to find out the key of the room placed inside the syringe waste. And another antidote was present there. But instead of doing this by himself, he throws Amanda inside. After trying so much, Amanda finally finds out the key, but the time runs out. And the door gets shut forever. After being alone, Xavier enters a room where he finds out S number. With which he solves the puzzle of Jigsaw. Jigsaw had written the secret code at the back of everyone in the rainbow color. In order to find the code, he kills him. And there they find out the thing that was connecting all of them. That was that instead of Daniel, everyone had gone to jail. And Daniel's father was responsible for sending them to jail against false charges. And when Xavier finds out about this, he comes out to find Daniel. Now, Addison finds another room, where another antidote was kept in the glass casing. She ignores the recorder and tries to find out the antidote. But she gets trapped in it. It cuts her veins off, and she dies there. And if she had listened to the tape, maybe she might have found the key to the glass box. And she might not be killed, and would have found the antidote. Xavier listens to her shouting and reaches there. And he takes out her code, and leaves her for dying there. After a while, a girl dies of poison. After finding codes from many people's body, Xavier tries to find Daniel. There Eric sees his son's life in danger, and loses his temper. He hits Jigsaw real hard to find out the location of his son. And after a while, Jigsaw agrees to take him to the exact location. But he makes a condition, that he will go there alone. Xavier follows them, and reaches to the washroom. And he asks them to tell him their number. He also threatens Amanda to give her number. Then Amanda asks him that, how would she know the number written on her back? And Xavier thrashes out the skin at his back by cutting it. Xavier dies after being hit by Daniel during the fighting with both of them. On the other side, Eric enters the place Jigsaw had told him about. He enters the basement and the force team also enters there. But they can't find the people in video monitor, and also couldn't find the victims. And then they find out that this was not that house, and they were actually seeing a recorded video. Which means, whatever had happened to the victims had already occurred before capturing Jigsaw. On the other side, Eric enters the washroom in search of his son. But there, he finds neither Amanda nor Daniel. Then he finds a dead body in the bathtub. When he gets closer, the dead body injects him, and makes him unconscious. When he wakes up, Eric finds out himself chained. A tape reveals the secret that there was another mastermind apart from Jigsaw. And that mastermind was none other than Amanda, who did all this to take revenge from Eric. Because she was never on drugs, but Eric put a false charge against her and arrested her. And she was jailed, and also got addicted to the drugs in the prison. Actually, Eric had ruined her life, but Jigsaw made her to give up drugs, and gave her a new life. And told her the importance of life. She gets impressed by Jigsaw and starts working under him. And here, her first prey was Eric. And she intentionally got herself included with the prisoners. only to complete her mission. And Jigsaw had also told Eric that his son was in a safe place. He was indicating towards him and Amanda says, "Game over." And the doors shut down forever. And the movie ends here with a devilish smile of Jigsaw. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to my channel and stay tuned for more upcoming videos.